trying to create one new account. Okay, I'll name this account as a Pro Coding Skills. Okay. .com, and I'll give my website name is brocodingskills.com, and I'll rate myself as a heart, and I don't give my phone number, and consider that this is on a prospect and industry is education. Okay, these are the random details. The main important in this, you can see the red color asterisk symbol, right? So this denotes this field is required in order to save this record. If I don't provide any value in this field, then it will throw an error for you. Okay, it's not just a required field, there are other requirements based on the validation rules. Like, let's say, hey, based on the phone number or a rating, I need to throw a validation. That's a different concept where you don't see a red color symbol, but it will give an error. Okay, for now I'm going back and I'm saving this message, and I'm saving this particular account. Okay, account got saved. So generally here, whatever you are seeing here in this, first we'll understand here we have a details and you have a related section. What does it mean, related? Account, contacts, opportunities, cases, notes and attachments, partners, and we have many related objects. Related in the sense where being account being a parent and these being a child. Account being a parent and these being a child. Okay, in this Salesforce we have two types of relationships. One is master detail relationship and one is lookup relationship. One is lookup relationship, where if this is an account, if this is an account, I have a contact one and I have a contact two. Now imagine this way, if I have a contact one, contact two. So whenever I'm trying to create a contact, I'll select my account while filling my contact name. Here the account name is Pro Coding Skills. So it means for one Pro Coding Skills, how many contacts we have? Those two contacts will gonna show up here. Now the question goes here, what if I delete this account from the Salesforce? It will delete both the contacts, that is true. What if I restores this contact? It restores this contact. Okay, let's imagine this is done, right? So now can I create contact without account? Yes, in this case we can able to create a contact without account, it is allowed. Okay, let's go back and check it out. Let's go to contacts. Okay, click on new. I'm selecting as a Mr. Lakshmi Deepak and I'm saving it. Now you can see here I can select my contact. Let's say if your account is not showing up, you can click this search symbol. Let's say it is not showing in, click on this search results, it will open a model. You can do more search. In our case we know the account, so I'm selecting it and I'm saving. Okay, this is one. Now if I go to my accounts, how many accounts we have? I'm going to Pro Coding Skills. Now I can see contact, one contact, right? Let me create another contact. If I click new directly from account, account is auto-populated. Why it is auto-populated? Because I'm clicking related list. From the related list, then it is auto-populating. So let's say, and I'm saving it. We got here, right? Let me go back. Contacts, I'll create new, I'll say Mr. X-Man and I'm saving it. So here am I selected any account? I'm allowed to select, I'm allowed to create contact without account information. That's not a mandatory by default. Now let's go back. I'm open this record. I'll go back and delete it. I'll go back and delete it. Before, let's go back. I'll open this in a new tabs. So now I'll click here, delete. This account got deleted by default. Contacts got deleted. You don't have a contacts now. Now let's go back. How to restore? So from the app launcher, you have an option called recycle bin. You can look for recycle bin and you can select it. I can see restore. As soon as you restore, accounts and the contacts will be reflected. Imagine I did a charter. Let's say charter I did it. Hey, this is for test. This is for test, okay. If I delete, will my charter will restore? Yes. Even though if I delete my account and if I restore, let's go back, undo. Charter, you have your charter. Okay, all these things will be restored if everything going smooth. Good, any question on this? Any questions?
Okay, if you create the contacts without link to an account, where it will reflect?
It will be stored in the contact only. You will not able to see anywhere else. You can see only in here. Now that let's say, if customer asked you, in a way that, hey, whenever I'm creating a new record, a customer selects a heart, then he should provide his phone number and website is required. When customer selects a heart, then he should provide a phone number without. So this is something on a dependency basis, right? Phone is not required every time. Phone is required only when rating equal to hot. So this is like something like a conditional check. These type of things can be implemented using a concept called validation rule in Salesforce. How this can be implemented? Let's go to setup. Object manager. Account. Validation rules. New rating underscore phone check. This is just a name. Now here what is here rating is a which type of field? Here rating is a which type of field? Which type of field is this? Whether you are entering the data or you are selecting a value. How many values you are selecting? So it is a drop down value. The data type is pick list. So for a pick list value, you have a condition called is pick value from functions. Here we have a functions called is pick value. Is pick value. Here what is the pick list field? So you can click on select insert field and then rating and literal is case sensitive. Let's say text literal within double quotes hot. This is first condition and next condition you are saying is null. Phone number is null. If it is null, then throw an error. If it is not null, you don't want to throw an error, right? If it is null, if it is hot and phone number is null, then we need to throw an error. validation rule, we need to check for a wrong data. This is a wrong data. Yep. Phone is required when rating is hot. And you wanted to show a message at the top of a page. I mean, let's say if I don't have this, if I click save, where you are getting? Here you need to show a message, or you need to show a field level message. So then we need to select field level message, and which field? Phone number. Phone. Save. Now this validation rule is active. Now you can see active and it is saved. Now let's see. Cancel. Now if I edit and I save, why it is not throwing an error? Being phone is null, right? Not fielded, right? But showing an error. The problem here we need to understand, phone is the text type. When it is a text type, it is always a good to check is blank. Now instead of is null, we need to check for is blank. Is now it is blank of phone number, because phone is not an integer type or a number type, so it's a text. Always we need to check for a blanks in a validation rules. So is blank. Now I'm saving it. Got saved. No, it will throw an error. Phone is required when the rating is hot. Let's say fine.
It depends on our number.
Sorry?
Phone number error field is
there. But you need to display error message at a phone, right? For this validation. You can display error message at description by saying phone is required. You can select whatever field you wanted. Here you can type whatever message you wanted. So this is a message, not a field.